As much as I enjoy hodling and witnessing my coins and tokens grow on their own, I know for a fact that crypto has much more to offer. But with the inflation of gas prices, it's honestly very hard to muster the confidence to do anything when the transaction itself can oftentimes cost more than whatever I'm messing around with. This is why I think it's time to go outside the box and see what some side chains have to offer. In case you've got no idea what a sidechain is, I recommend watching this video right there in the corner. But to explain it quickly, imagine as if Ethereum is a freeway that recently has just too much traffic and has become a nuisance to take. So then, people built roads parallel to Ethereum so that we can still get to where we need to go. These parallel roads are the sidechains. I'll be looking at a small selection of chains that our team is fond of and explore why that is, taking a look at their unique features and solutions. And in case you're curious about what the future has to offer for pillar users and sidechains, make sure to subscribe and also join our Discord server linked below. Without further ado, let's check out Polygon. First, it's important to mention that Polygon seems to be in a league of its own because it behaves differently from other sidechains, as it touches base with Ethereum every 256 blocks. That makes Polygon what they're calling a commit chain, because it commits way more often to the mainnet. In terms of scalability, Polygon looks to be very well served. Projects can spin up a dedicated blockchain network with the advantages of a standalone chain and of Ethereum combined. And for security, chains using Polygon can opt in for their security as a service feature that periodically checks the network for fraudulent activity and other validators for a fee. Also, this security feature will come at the cost of less independence and potential flexibility for the chain. Polygon is well positioned to be a good alternative to projects wanting to escape Ethereum's clogging and high gas prices. And it's already compatible with many common tools and platforms, such as our good friend Wallet Connect. Binance Smart Chain's focus appears to be speed, gotta go fast, which was already the focus of its sister chain, Binance Chain. But unlike that one, the younger sys also features a much more friendly environment for developers to come up with high-performance decentralized applications. It also has the advantage of being compatible with multiple currencies from different blockchains, allowing users to interact with a buttload of projects, among them the infamous PancakeSwap, BurgerSwap, and BakerySwap. Crypto these days is either food or dogs, and I really don't get it. Jumping to our last sidechain, xDai. Giving it a quick read, xDai looked to be the most non-Chad of all the sidechains, advertising the peace of mind inherent to stablecoins. Because while its native coin is xDai, big surprise there, and that is pegged 1-to-1 to DAI. So a chain that operates with a stable coin where the transactions and fees utilize the same coin, and where high fees and long waiting times are nowhere to be found. That might just steer the ship of naysayers towards crypto. And since you can experience a world of dApps right here, I'd say xDai is looking pretty cozy already. No crazy volatility, fast access to financial innovation. I mean, you gotta give crypto a chance now, man. Coming to this point, I think it's easy to understand why these three are the constant examples I hear about when discussing sidechains. Among them, anyone would be pretty well covered crypto-wise, whatever they want to experience within crypto. I'd say the closer we get to this diverse bunch and potentially more sidechains, the better. After all, diversity is very often just plain good strategy. Remember to subscribe to our channel just so you never miss what's coming, And don't forget to get your Pillar wallet right here. As always, thank you for watching.